Alrighty, time for round two. I'm on the play, and there's an ancestral. Alright, I'm in, I guess. Let's see if I go to ancestral myself. I can still play a mox, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. Hopefully my opponent doesn't have misstep. I would not mind my opponent force of willing. Mental misstepping is gonna be a little more annoying, but I don't think I want to wait till turn three, so, because I can't have mana drain backup on turn two here, so I think ancestraling on one makes the most sense. Don't actually have to play the mox now, given that my opponent played some things. Ooh, what is my opponent's turn one play? Dark Confidant? Alright. It's a card. The question now is, do I repeal it now or later? I think I repeal it at the end of my opponent's turn, thus that I can mana drain it when it comes back down. Revealing Underground Sea. Alright. So what am I playing as? Maybe like a bug deck, maybe a blue-black combo deck, like a Tendrils deck of some kind. Don't know. Could have mana drains in it. Could be like a Grixis control deck. Alright, I'm just going to play Island, and the reason is I want Flusterstorm up in case my opponent has counter back up here. For the Dark Confidant. There's five cards in hand, one of which is Dark Confidant. And if it gets cast, I will in fact drain it. Alright, did not get cast. I think now I will use Strip Mine since I'm not really doing a whole lot here. Alright. So opponent is wary about running into mana drain is my assessment here. Unless they've got like a dig through time or something that they're gonna cast end of turn. Also, I think they're straight blue-black. Getting the third underground seed there will indicate that. Wasteland. So this could be like a, not landstill exactly, but just like a four-color controller, or not four-color, a land-heavy control deck. All right, I don't need to cast this Brainstorm yet. I might at some point here, but I don't really have the tools to fight over Mental Misstep, and I would like Brainstorm to resolve. Ooh, I like Back to Basics too. Alright, the Back to Basics makes my hand good enough, I think. A bunch of counters and a Back to Basics, but I'll play the land. I was debating whether to keep the land in hand for Brainstorm purposes, but I think I like what's going on enough here that I can just go ahead and wait. We have something. You can't cast Dark Confidant that way. Is this a Chalice of the Void? Alright, I guess I'll respond by casting Brainstorm. And okay, I could put like Flusterstorm Misdirection back. Probably just let Chalice resolve. And draw. Actually, I wanted to play Vendilion end of turn there, I think. I clicked and the click went through. Mox Sapphire is kind of annoying because it makes my Back to Basics plan a little less good. Alright, well now I'm going to cast Vendilion Click for sure. And I'm going to be shuffling away the Flusterstorm that's on top of my deck. Well, one's got five cards in hand. One's a Dark Confidant that they just refuse to cast. So I don't know what's up with that. We'll see what happens with the rest in a second here. One way or another, I'm going to see some cards. Either my opponent's going to start countering, or Vendilion Click's going to resolve and I'm going to get to look at my opponent's hand, but regardless, something's going to happen. Alrighty, looks like Vendilion Click resolves, so let's have a peek, shall we? Dark Confidant, Force of Will, Mana Leak, Tinker, Yawgmoth's Will. Well, don't really want any of these things to resolve, but at least Tinker takes a little bit more commitment. I could see taking Dark Confidant here. Could see taking Tinker. Could see taking Yawgmoth's Will. I think I'm actually just going to take Yawgmoth's Will. It feels like that's the most potentially dangerous. Alright, let's sec. Scalding Tarn. Actually, you know, Flusterstorm still works. Maybe I shouldn't have shuffled it away. Under Chalice, of course, then I drew a one drop that also gets chaliced. Let's see. I guess I'm just going to cast Time Walk here. If I had a Jason deck, I would be a little happier about casting Time Walk. But, ooh, Gush was a good find here. But I am not too close to having that, so it's just Time Walk. This also makes Dark Confident a little bit worse. Library of Alexandria. I guess I don't have Back to Basics in play, so I will play my library. And I think I'm just discarding Soul Ring here. You know what? Oh. Of course, there's a Wasteland in play. Yeah, I'll discard Soul Ring. I mean, I could just discard Island, but I guess the Chalice is not going anywhere unless my opponent tinkers. So, wow, my opponent really does not want to cast Dark Confidant. I don't understand. All right. I think I'm going to let... I'm going to try to race Dark Confidant here. And leaving my opponent with Mana Leak, Tinker, Force of Will. The fact that I'm going to get hit my opponent down to 8 makes me a lot happier. Ooh, my opponent's casting spells? I like casting spells. Crucible of Worlds. I don't love that. But, you know, it actually doesn't... It just makes Back to Basics less of a plan, but honestly it wasn't that much of a plan against all those Moxes to begin with, so I will allow Crucible. Black Lotus. Well, it doesn't do a whole lot, but I guess I get to cast all my spells here. I can play the Back to Basics. Let's see, if I play Back to Basics, I'll still have Drain, Force, Misdirection up. If I don't play Back to Basics, though, I can Drain and then Hard Cast Force and then Misdirect, pitching Back to Basics. Yeah, I actually like that better. And Back to Basics doesn't really shut off my opponent's cards all that well. Opponent revealed Soul Ring, which does not do anything because of the Chalice. Let's see. Replayed Underground Sea with the Crucible of Worlds. It's going to hit me down to 14. And not go for anything, which makes sense. Alright, Repeal. So I can repeal Dark Confidant if I so desire. I'm actually getting to the point where even a Tinker won't save my opponent. Go on, flip Force of Will. Nope, hit Strip Mine. Well, Strip Mine Crucible is a combo, but don't think my opponent's going to have time for that. Given that I'm smashing with a Vendilion Click here, my opponent's at 4 lives. Also, if my opponent pitches to Force of Will, they go to 3. So I think things are not looking great for my opponent at this point. I think it's possible my opponent should have cast Dark Confidant much sooner, but drawing that Vendilion Click was pretty good. Alright, so I'm going to get attacked down to 12. Presumably this is where my opponent would go for a Tinker here, but alright, now I just have millions of counters and a Vendilion Click, so I like that. Alright, Force of Will is off, and if anything gets flipped with Dark Confidant, they die. Nope, they flipped Tropical Island. I guess they could have Abrupt Decay. Yeah, my opponent's playing this game a little strangely, I have to admit. Keeping the Dark Confidant hand for a lot of turns makes sense against Mana Drain, except opponent's hand is also Tinker Yawgmoth's Will. With a hand like that, I'd just play the Dark Confidant. If it gets countered, then you can just play your other cards. And not casting Tinker last turn, I mean... Is there nothing my opponent can tinker for that does anything? Well, library is a card, I suppose. Yeah, I don't know where... how my opponent thinks they're going to win this game, I guess, is the question. Alright, well, I am going to manage in the tinker here, because... it doesn't seem like there's a big disadvantage to... just trying to stop tinker. I mean, who knows what comes out of that. And I still have double force and misdirection. I mean, I can't cast all of them, but actually I can... Oh, no, I can. I can't cast all of them, and... oh, I can even pay for Mana Leak. So, yeah, I can hard cast force and then pitch Back to Basics to cast second force and pitch repeal to cast misdirection or something along those lines. Is hard cast Force of Will? Sure, I will also hard cast Force of Will. I guess I should sack my Scalding Tarn. Scaldarino here. Boom. Alright, Mana Drain happens. I draw. I'm not going to bother playing Jace because I can just attack my opponent to death with Vindaline Click. Hiya. Alright. Sideboarding. Don't mind Remora here. I do like Chunin, Nemesis, and Vindaline Click. I don't know about Misstep. Actually, it doesn't sound great against a deck that has Chalices. Don't want to steal Sabotage because I don't actually care about Chalices. I could take these Propagandas out. Blusterstorm. Maybe I take out a Misstep for a Norod. Norod seems like it would be good against my opponent, so let's try that. Alright, on the draw round two, yeah, this is a keepable hand. If my opponent's got a bunch of Moxes, Norod can be good. I'm not going to lead with the Norod, though. I'm going to lead with Preordain. Ooh, I like both these cards. Put these on the top. In fact, I might cast both those cards next turn. Hopefully this isn't a Dark Confidant. That would be annoying. Alright, Dark Confidant is a solid card. Draw with Library. And play a Mox Emerald, I suppose. Yeah, I actually don't see Remora being a good play here. Just because there's already a Dark Confidant in play, so my opponent's drawing extra cards. Revealed Ancient Tomb. Okay. For those not aware, that's this thing. Land that taps for two and deals two to you. Don't know why that's my opponent's deck, but who knows. Anyway, I don't want to play Remora because if I play Remora, then I'm tied down on the upkeep while the Dark Confidant's hitting me. That doesn't seem great. I'd rather just wait and then repeal my opponent's Dark Confidant. Though I think Library is going down here. My opponent Demonic Tutored, and I assumed it would be Strip Mine. Twas. Alright. Take a little damage. Probably set up Repeal at some point, though. Alright, I think I just go Land Go, and then again, end of turn, Repeal Dark Confidant. Revealed Force of Will. Chunk for 15. We're down to 15. And then next turn I can play Remora and Ancestral Recall. See if this gets forced. If it doesn't get forced, my opponent has to discard too, which is nice. Alright, I got Mana Drained. I've got all sorts of options now. Opponent does have Force. Alright, so let's cast Mystic Remora. See if that resolves. It does, so I think I just go Land Go. I could cast Ancestral, but I'd rather just keep Repeal up. Revealed Library of Alexandria and has 3 mana floating. So I would have assumed my opponent wouldn't play Ancient Tomb last turn unless they had no other lands to play. They revealed Library. Maybe they don't. They only have colorless lands, which would be decent for me. Also, yeah, I might have to Ancestral if it turns out I have to fight a counter war over something. Otherwise, didn't use the mana. Alright. Let's cast Repeal again. Opponent again will have to discard if this resolves. And if they cast Force, then I draw for more, unless they pitch cast Force and then pay with Ancient Tomb, which would be fun with me, I suppose. And then I can play Jace with a Remora in play, which is nice. And still bounce Dark Confidant. So Dark Confidant's one of the cards that this deck is worst against, and I feel like I'm fighting it alright. I mean, I guess game one my opponent just didn't cast it for a bunch of turns, but I would have potentially been able to just counter it. In this game, it's drawing extra cards, but I'm fighting back. Let's see what ends up happening here. Opponent has a lot of options. They can hard cast Force, but then they can't use Library, and I draw for Mora. They can pitch cast Force. I guess I don't know what other blue cards they have. They can just let that resolve and discard. Alright, and just discard it. See, look. Repeals, like, Vindicate. It's just insane. And I drew another Jace. I'm not tapping out for Jace here. I have a nice Ancestor Recall waiting. Yeah, well, my opponent library, that's fine. They're kind of choked on colored mana here. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if they played a land this turn, but still lots of colorless. And I think I'm going to end of turn go for Ancestral with Mana Drain up, and then hopefully if that all works, I get to Jace. Again, Counter Wars with Remora in play are pretty profitable. Either your opponent grossly overpays for the first one, and then you counter it, then they counter back, and you draw at least one card, and they used a ton of mana, or you just draw multiple cards off Remora. Could have let my opponent discard, but given that they're librarying, that's not all that profitable. Let's see what their response is here. Alright. Just letting it resolve. Alright, in that case, I'm probably going to go for a dig through time. Again, because I don't really care if this resolves or not. Actually, I'm just going to tap three. Dig all the way through time. And this is, you know, comparable to resolving Ancestral. I guess it's Treasure Cruise versus dig there. And so I wouldn't be surprised if my opponent fought over it. Also, I'm tapped out, which has to make it a little bit more appealing. Mana Leak. Okay. And are you letting me reward? You are. Alright, I drew a Soul Ring. Alright. I could force, but that's just trying to draw two cards off Dig. Or I'll lose two cards off Dig in order to get Dig, which doesn't seem like it's a great deal. Land. Soul Ring. I assume my opponent doesn't misstep given that Ancestral happened there. Play a Jace. Wouldn't be surprised if my opponent Ancestral's in response, or rather, Libraries in response, not Ancestral's, and then casts Force of Will. Oh, maybe another Mana Leak off Ancient Tomb. This is what Vintage is all about. Alright, let's draw off Mystic Remora here. Ooh. It's kind of nice. Do I force then Fluster? I guess I force leaving up Fluster. Yeah. It doesn't matter actually which way, so I'll just leave with the Fluster. Basically, even though I could Fluster both Force of Will and Mana Leak, I could, my opponent can just re-counter the Jace. So. Alright, looks like my opponent will not be fighting over Jace with Force of Will. Alright, I will draw some cards. Just want Force of Wills at this point. Or back to Lotus Timewalk back to basics. I am just drawing out of control well with this deck. Maybe this deck is just busted. I could Timewalk here, but it actually doesn't. I think I'll just cast back to basics. Oh, well, that's game. I mean, my opponent's going to force it, and I'm just going to force back, so they have to have double Force of Will. I guess one reason to Time Walk is to set up being able to counter it twice, but my opponent would have countered Time Walk just as well, I assume. And if Back to Basics resolves, I don't see how my opponent's winning this game. I just, you know, cast Armageddon targeting my opponent, destroying five lands. And then I get to Time Walk with True Name Nemesis, which is even better. Ancient Tomb, Soul Ring, triggering Mystic Remora. I could even Null Rod, I don't really even want to. Alright, Crucible is fine. I already played a land this turn. And even just playing lands and using them as one shots does not bother me that much. I guess Flooded Strand can go get a basic. I could, yeah. I was actually going to consider not paying because I was going to play Nemesis, Time Walk, get to Jace, Time Walk, get to Jace again, have Mana Drain, second Nemesis. So, alright, 2-0 with Remora Blue somehow.